Excellencies, Ambassadors, ladies and gentlemen. I am now in Bogor, just finished having a meeting with my president and will have another meeting in 2 hours. So from Bogor, I'm very pleased to witness the signing of the grand agreements between Indonesia, Mozambique, and Zimbabwe. An African proverb says, hold a true friend with both hands. As your friend, these grand agreements reflect Indonesia's commitment to extend our support to share one another's burden, especially during challenging times. Without a doubt, a friend in need is a friend indeed. Ambassadors, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, from time to time, Indonesia and African nations share similar challenges. In the past, our countries endured colonialism. Today, we face a common challenge, climate change. Devastating cyclones have brought immense loss to our people. In March 2019, Cyclone Idai severely affected northern Mozambique and Zimbabwe. During the past week, the Indonesian people were struck by Cyclone Seroja in East Nusa Tenggara and earthquake in East Java. Recovery process in the aftermath of disasters takes time. To ease the suffering of the people, to build back the infrastructure, and to get the economy back in gear. This becomes a greater obstacle to overcome at a time when we are all still battling the COVID-19 pandemic. Natural disaster coupled with the impact of coronavirus is disastrous. Therefore, we need to stand together and share the burden. Cooperation and solidarity are keys. This is the foundation of our partnership. Excellencies, Ambassador, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia and Africa share a long and strong historical background. We also share a common destiny that goes beyond goals of the Bandung Conference in 1955. We have shared aspiration that goes beyond political rhetoric as we strive to promote socio-economic prosperity of our people. In achieving this, Indonesia has initiated several endeavors, including the new Asian-African Partnership, the Indonesian-African Forum in 2018, and the Indonesia-Africa Infrastructure Dialogue in 2019. Indonesia is also committed to support Africa's agenda at the global level, including G20 Africa Partnership and Agenda 2063 in Africa through Compact with Africa. Going forward, our strong bond should also be reflected in our efforts to tackle current challenges, including natural disaster and effort to mitigate COVID-19. Furthermore, Indonesia stands ready to forge closer relations in the long run, not only as your traditional partner, but also as your future development partner. Ambassadors, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, Indonesia hopes these grand agreements will contribute positively to the recovery efforts and reconstruction process in Mozambique and Zimbabwe. Rest assured, Indonesia is committed to hold you with both hands in addressing common challenges and promoting prosperity and development of our nation. Last but not least, allow me to also wish my Muslim brothers and sisters Ramadan Karim. May the blessing of this holy month be upon us all. Colleagues, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay united. I thank you very much.